And then the stories like they show on with people that are children who have a really, really, really hard life and everything. God knows how hard all of your lives are. He knows all about what you do, even when you're in private. He knows about how you think. And of course, when there's somebody like that, they're not going to become a business person in this country and make it big, obviously. And so they're blessed, truly. And they'll be made whole there. And of course, they're going to get in. Even little babies that were abortion, God knows what they would have been if they hadn't been. And they'll be put right there where they belong, and they didn't sin. It's not about, there's this whole other thing that's going on with people that they think that the things of the flesh are the blessings, and that this life is supposed to be wonderful for some reason, and it's not. That's the whole thing. And if you expect this life to be wonderful, then you're going to be disappointed if you don't find that the American dream is really just dishonest, and it's just a lie, and it's a thief, it's a business person, and then they're not even happy, and they go out and probably start doing hard drugs and stuff like that. I don't even want to get into that. But people want to, like, people that are already rich, I mean, I've seen them go to church, they have a mansion, and they ask other people for money for art they make that's not even that good, and they already have that much money to give in the first place, and they think they're blessed. I mean, you're supposed to be a church, you're supposed to be a temple for that spirit, you're supposed to have the word of God written on you, and then only you'll know who you are, and everybody else, it's like, I'm not here to do Christ's job. If he wanted you to know what I'm telling you, you would have already told everybody else what I'm telling you now. And so you're not going to listen, but it has to be posted. And those who listen and laugh and turn against it more, then that's the reason they're here anyway, is to do sin. God lets it happen. But those who have put up with other sins, one day I was like, how come I can't have a woman come out of the concrete? You gave Adam one, and he said, why do you think? And I thought about it and came up with the answer. Christ doesn't die because he's sinful or of his own sins. It's other people's sins. Otherwise, who's going to kill him? If he was the only one here, he'd never leave if there was no sin. And so if God made a woman out of the concrete and they didn't get to the tree of good and evil and everything else, then they wouldn't be sinners. And what, am I going to kill them and put them back in the concrete? God going to? He doesn't kill people. Satan does, and Satan can't heal. He can only kill. And even to the point where he begged Jesus, don't die. You can save yourself on the cross. Don't die, Jesus. Why don't you save yourself? He can't save himself. Ha ha. He said, I can, but that's not the Father's purpose, and it's not my purpose. It's to do what he wants. And I'm not going to, this isn't where I made heaven. I'm going to make a place. I'm going to beat death. And that's what Easter coming up is about. And I'm giving you the true point. And those who hate me hate the Father. If they hate me because of what I say about him, because the only way to get to him is through Christ, which comes out of my mouth, because it's the truth and it's the life in me that talks now. It's not my emotions, it's not my highs or lows, it's only his word that's the true spirit of prophecy. And I was invited to the Holy Supper, and you've been invited, because, and you're here now. If you're here with me, then you're invited. And everyone here on the planet's invited to join. It's a great feast, so welcome aboard to my church. It's free, and they'll probably erase it. Check out my other thesis. It's a longer one, and it's about the point of the sword. It's more dealing with why bad things happen and everything else. And again, I can't stress enough how women will see a little cute Bambi, and oh, it's so cute! Oh, it's so cute! I mean, it is really cute. I love my cat, and she's really cute, but that has nothing to do with God. That was our relationship that we'll share forever under God. That's not a blessing or anything. It's just the way life is. I was lucky to have her and find her before she accidentally got killed. If it rains and snows and storms on somebody, is it because they're more or less evil than you? No. Are you so blessed and you sit there in front of all those people in an earthquake and they lost their kids? Yours good. I'm glad it survived, but who's really blessed here? If they're truly going to heaven, and this place isn't heaven, it sucks if they died painlessly, and it's not supposed to happen, because God's purpose has to happen, which is what I already told you. But I can't stress enough the people who are sinners the most and call themselves Christians and other different religions, and they're on TV, and if you have the wood, you take it out of your own eyes like I have, you'll suddenly look around and you'll be terrified of what you see, and it'll be, you'll even be called a schizophrenic, You'll tell people the truth in your own family, and it doesn't, to you, it'll sound wonderful. It's God's word, and they won't want it. They will act like they're listening. They won't even be listening. As soon as you're done, they'll change the subject over and over, and they are embarrassed by you. Nobody will have you any in the supermarkets. If they even ask or they're talking about something and you're kind and you give them a good word and they say this or that and you say, yeah, but this and that, and they're like, you're crazy. Well, that's going to happen here. It's allowed. But I just can't stress enough how, I mean, yeah, a retarded kid is cute, really cute and good at stuff, and him and his doggy and that and all that stuff, that's fine, the emotional highs and everything that they get from it. I get it. But to sit there and call that, oh, God's in the room now. I feel God's spirit. That's your spirit. That's the flesh. The spirit of life is pure. It's life. That's it. It'll share with you again if it wants you later in the next earth. And you'll have your genes risen there. If not, you'll be wrapped up here and we'll be called Satan, who is the devil in the flesh, wrapped up on it since the first sin. And you can get a new name, and it's called a word of God or a child of God. And don't go looking for them in the desert or in the inner rooms anymore. And quit going and getting refrigerator magnets to say, I forgive, God bless, God bless. And Jesus could walk on water. How come you can't? Because nobody else is perfect. That's why, man. And then they're using them on television right now to make money. To make people feel those emotions and to make them feel all warm. And they're using that poor kid, and he's been forgiven for their sins. The rest of you on Fox News, Sarah Palin, all of you at Fox, you're not getting in. You're a loser, man, in the Lord. You've been emailed so many times, and you do that stuff on purpose because I asked you not to, because God said not to. And you use that kid. See what you're so evil you don't even see it. I give up, dude. That's why he didn't tell you anything. I'm the loser telling you everything. I'm a stupid idiot.